Well, time to get a little bit of booyah with the Dancing Queens, as I like to actually call them. I call them the Dancing Queens.
Oh, my God. Well, this is Frank Saltarelli and Alex Red here tonight.
Tonight on this episode 25.
Booyah!
From Orlando, Florida, at a combined weight of 308 pounds, the debt collector, RJD, and Sean Holly. The Booyah Club!
Flipper is part of the Booyah Club?
This is the Booyah Club. Apparently, the Flip and Dip.
The Flip and Dip here tonight on ARW. This is funny.
We got the Flip and Dip here, and yeah, hopefully they don't come up short like Sean usually does, but...
Well, Sean's always a little short.
I like to call them the Dancing Queens.
He's always a little short. Now look at that nice shirt. Why does he have string all over him? I don't understand why RJD has string all over him.
He's showing off. He's booyah! You know, the string will flow in the wind. Because he's a dancing queen.
Yeah. Oh, look at all the robes! What a mess!
That's a moment of booyah right there,
that's
Frank.
That's a big moment of booyah.
But, you know, this is a very interesting team, and we're about to have another very interesting team come out here.
Okay, let's see what we got going on.
The ring is a little bit of a mess.
Yes, extremely.
The Booyah movement took over 2020, and apparently it's taken over 2021 here, too.
Well, what's worse than COVID? Booyah or COVID? What's worse?
At this point, I don't know. We got to ask Big E. He loves Booyah.
Oh, yeah. I just saw that. Was it on SmackDown?
It was like a month ago or something.
Yeah, in a Booyah shirt.
Oh, here we go.
What's Flipper doing?
This is how we're kicking off tonight, too.
And their opponents.
This is a very interesting team right here.
You just got the circus.
From Miami, Florida, he is still the Gold Girl favorite, Jerry Swirl, and his partner representing Latin America, Mr. Latino Gang, Leo Knox.
Leo Knox has tighties on. He has tighties on.
I'm a little nervous right here. Leo, you can tell, is kind of... Leo's a little nervous to... Oh, God, he does. I see what you're saying now. The Golden Girl tighties.
I hope he's not into sucking ass here tonight.
This is the team of the Golden Gods.
Oh, God.
Is what they're calling themselves, the Golden Gods.
Oh, God.
Wait. Is that...
Oh, whoa. Some explicit lyrics here tonight on the topic.
Well, we are extreme. We are the new face of extreme. We definitely aren't PG.
Oh, definitely not. And Leo just in shock.
I'm in shock too right now. This is a very interesting matchup. You look at the Golden Gods and then you look at the Booyah Club or the Dancing Queens, whatever. This is a very unique matchup. Right? Only at Atomic can you see this.
Oh, man. We're kicking off right now. These two
it's
teams.
A very interesting, you know, because we've seen the back and forth over weeks with Leo Knox and Jerry Swirls where, you know, Jerry's kind of been coming to the aid of Leo to be there and help him because he's been on such
well,
a tremendous
friends.
Loss. You
well,
know?
I mean, but they're friends. They've grown up in the business together, and now tonight they're going to join forces. And now you have Flipper and RJ forming the Booyah Club. I mean, it's a lot of storytelling here tonight.
Well, that's our moment of Booyah to kick off... Episode 25 here of Extreme Takeover Thursday.
Oh, yeah.
You know, he's over here focusing on the... Yeah, that. But
okay,
he's got to
match.
Remember he has Leo Knox behind him.
Yeah, man. Leo... Oh, Leo making him
That's
pay.
What I'm talking about right there.
What a kick in the mouth, and there comes Flipper. Oh, wait a minute. That team's not really looking like it's working too well. Oh, misses. Oh, Leo just beating up Flipper right now, tagging in.
Jerry Swirls has kind of been like the teacher. I can't believe I'm saying that. The teacher for Leo Knox when it comes to whatever this goldenness is.
Oh, my. And oh, with the forearm to the face. And they do another tag team. They're actually working like a cohesive unit. Oh, wait a minute. The booty cheeks. Oh. The booty cheeks right into Flipper. And oh, he twirls booty cheeks right into Flipper. God. Ass everywhere. One, two, kick out.
That's the wob. Oh. The wet ass butt.
Oh, the wet ass butt. Wet ass booty.
Oh, no.
And there he goes. Double. Oh, right there. Flipper on his back, flailing like the fish he is.
Very interesting to see Jerry Swirls and Leo Knox as a team. I mean, these guys go way back.
Oh, he misses.
Big miss right there. But, you know, they go way back as friends from being, you know, ring announcers to referees to their first time ever teaming together.
Yeah, but they're working well together. I think they've been probably training at school or whatnot because they're really working like a well-oiled machine. But right now, Flipper cutting off the ring, RJ in. The leader of the Booyah Club.
If there's one thing ARW has, it's good tag teams. And these are this is the introduction of two new tag teams for ARW.
Oh, another chop by RJ onto Jerry Swirls. What's he doing right now? Flipping him up.
Flipping.
Oh. How is he choking him? He's choking him.
That was the Booyah hold.
The Booyah choke.
Oh. The flippy floppy.
The half arm elbow drop. The forearm drop. Oh, no, not enough power. Oh!
RJ needs to focus on this match because Sean Holly attempted to go in there for a tag, but his partner wasn't there.
Well, he loves the Booyah, and he's an attention.
I understand he loves the Booyah, but he needs to be there for his partner.
Oh, what a suplex by Leo. RJ rushing in.
Tag team match, and he's got to be there for his partner.
Huh? Oh, no. Oh!
He is going to feel that tomorrow.
He's tuning it up.
Tuning up the WAP.
The WAP.
The WAP. Oh, my God. Leo Knox onto Holly and RJ.
That was a double butt cheek drop.
Oh,
the golden sack. Where he goes. One, two, three, and it's all over.
Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, Jerry Swirls and Leo.
And the hug and the love between Leo and Jerry Swirls.
The golden gods, Leo Knox and Jerry Swirls, successful in their first time teaming together, and I wish I was not looking at that.
Jerry's doing the grind and the hump.
Well, this is very disturbing to say the least, but nonetheless, these two very successful in their first outing as a team.
I took the lenses out of my eyes so I could be blind right now and just see smudges moving around in circles.
I'm a little petrified.
Oh, my God.
The new lovers are successful here.
They're like the new golden lovers, but they can't wrestle as good.
They were good.
But not as much as the original golden lovers.
Nonetheless, though, Golden Gods successful in their debut.
On February 19th, 2021, for the last time at the Space Coast Convention Center, we wage an all-out war as we begin Chapter 5, celebrating our 4-year anniversary. Scheduled to appear with ARW favorites like Wes Briscoe, Shannon Moore, Jason Dugan, Chris Dane, Remy, and more. Plus, we'll see the debuts of the co-founder of GWAR, Techno Destructo, Trevor Aeon, The Awakening, formerly known as The Ascension, and one half of Grand Time, KTG. And we'll see the returns of the Warlord of Weird, Sid Bodhi, current comeback star, Madman Furgin, and impact star, The Undead Bride, Sue Young. It all goes down February 19th, 2021, for Chapter 5, All Out War. our four-year anniversary celebration at the Space Coast Convention Center, 301 Tucker Lane, in Cocoa, Florida. Tickets available now at eventbrite.com. Keyword, Atomic Wrestling.
And it is a triple threat match for the Atomic Next Level Championship. Introducing the first challenger.
Ooh, it's been a rough night tonight. A lot of craziness.
I mean, earlier we saw the Booyah Club and the WAB.
The WAB.
And that's how we kicked off the night. And now, what a hell of a
From
event.
Oh, there he is! Weighing 160
That crazy
pounds.
Son of a bitch.
He is the future. This is Remy!
A monster. An aerial dynamic monster.
This is by far the biggest opportunity Remy has ever had in his career. He is about to face two men who are on national TV regularly. I mean, Wes Briscoe with Impact Wrestling, of course. You know, you have D3 who's appeared in AEW, WWE, you name it. This is a huge opportunity for Remy to prove if he truly is next level.
Well, man, you see him in the counter. You see everybody. Everybody cheering. Everybody just in his presence alone is what just draws. And we're going to see here tonight, can Remy get to the next level?
And his opponent.
This right here is what we call an Italian god.
Oh, yeah. Spartan warrior.
From there he Rome, is. Italy, weighing 78 kilos, the Prince of Rome, D3.
D3 is the Prince of Rome, and tonight he is here to prove that he is next level and he is all elite.
Oh, there he is.
D3.
Right, look at the tattoos in his chest, just meshing so well with the Spartan uniform. Bloodline of a warrior is D3.
Bloodline? Yeah, absolutely. The all elite D3.
There he is. And the helmet is looking so shiny.
You know, we're just kicking off 2021. This is only our second show in here, and what a way to kick it off, because you got to think these guys have a lot to prove this year.
Oh, yeah.
This could be the breakout year for these gentlemen.
Anything's better than what 2020 was. 2020
I'm so glad we're done with that.
Yeah, that's dead in the water. Joe Biden came out with the cure to COVID. I mean, it's amazing.
We're cured.
No mask here at 2021. And here it is, D3 with the camping on. Love his outfit.
And introducing their opponent.
Well, when we talk about next level, we talk about someone who truly is bad to the bone.
Oh, yeah. With the lineage. You want to talk about bloodline of warriors. This is the man that comes straight from the womb with championship presence.
From Orlando, Florida, he is bad to the bone, and your current reigning and defending Atomic Next Level Champion, Wes Briscoe!
That is Wes Briscoe, the Atomic Next Level Champion. He's a former Atomic Heavyweight Champion.
Oh, yeah.
And
that gold looks so good.
He's bad to the bone. Well, Wes Briscoe, you know, you talk about the bloodline. Let's talk about his Hall of Fame father.
Oh, yeah, Hall of Fame. And uncle.
Yeah, Gerald Briscoe, and, of course, exactly. The line of Briscoes in his family, man.
Yeah, the Briscoe name, I mean, NWA World Champion, both of the brothers.
When you think of legendary and you think of professional wrestling, you think the Briscoe name is synonymous with that.
I mean, hell, his father was even a WWF Hardcore Champion back in the day. Remember that dude?
He was.
So there's gold on all levels, and Wes Briscoe here tonight is the next level of that legacy.
But is he bad to the bone enough to defeat and overcome Remy in D3? Because you got to think, he's got to have eyes in the back of his head for a match like this.
Well, he's the veteran in the group, so he has all the advantages needed to win and retain his championship here tonight. D3, you know, a vet in his own right. You know, he's been doing this a couple years now. Remy's the one that has to overcome all the years of experience and all the lineage and that warrior blood also D3 here tonight.
Well, it's safe to say this crowd here at this sold-out Melbourne show is clearly behind Briscoe.
I mean, it's a hell of a last name. It's like McDonald's. Sounds American.
It does. Most American name.
Yes, sir.
The following contest is for the Atomic Next Level Championship.
Big stage for both of these guys. All three of these guys.
Manifest their win.
I mean, who's your pick to win this? Because you got to think of the interesting dynamics here. Wes Briscoe is that more ground and pound sort of brawler, you know, but he has that amateur style, you know, almost like an MMA style he has. And then Remy's the high flyer.
Yes.
And D3, again.
D3 is a hybrid. He could do the ground and pound.
Both. I mean, great.
I mean, personally, this is how I want to break it down to you. I think with Wes, you know, with logic, you would say Wes is going to win this match. But if, in my heart of hearts, I'm really hoping that Remy gets the champ. And there he is. Look at the pose. Look at the reaction. And D3, you know, he's a good contender, but I think Remy with his explosiveness and Wes with his knowledge of the game and his lineage, it's a hard toss-up, but I'm going to go with Wes.
It's safe to bet on Briscoe, but, you know, I don't know. If I had to, I've always said that Remy is the future, and, I mean, here we are in 2021, and he's getting opportunities like this. I might think the future is now.
Well, we'll find out. It is 2021. COVID is gone. It disappeared. I'm kidding.
It's going to be here forever, unfortunately.
But still, it's 2021. It's a better year than it was last year. And Remy, I mean, it might be the time. It might be the time. 2021, the year of Remy.
Yeah, Remy, and you know, we have some folks who are wondering why we have Christmas decorations and all this set up. You know, it's very similar to what we did with the Halloween where we took over all of November.
Yes.
We're allowing Christmas to take over all of January.
Because who does not like Christmas? You have to be a bastard not to like Christmas.
2020 was a bad year, so instead of just one day, we're celebrating it all month.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, man. I appreciate it. This
presents for everyone, but the best gift that anyone could have would be walking out with the championship here tonight.
Yes. Very much so, and all three of these men are looking to bring this present back home to mama. And there he is. Oh, kick to the face, Wes, with the veteran instinct right there. Armbar! Armbar!
Armbar off the ropes right there as you see Briscoe. He's
wait,
a known
D3.
Submissionist.
Kick to the head!
And that's where we talk about you got to have eyes in the back of your head.
It's a triple threat match, so you have to know. Moves like that won't work because you will always have another man looking. And Remy! Oh, right into the crowd.
That right there is a VIP maneuver.
And D3 with the agility to get out the way. And oh, what a toss.
Well, the VIP fans here definitely getting some extraordinary VIP action.
Oh, yeah, man. Let the bodies hit the floor with that one.
It's kind of crazy how we filled up the building, too, because you got to think the opening match, you know, we had just VIPs. Now we have the whole building full.
Oh, yeah.
See how quick that can happen.
Asses in seats. That's what ARW does.
Sold out every show of last year that we had and continuing that into 2021.
And it's crazy. We did that with, you know, despite all
how,
the limitations.
Go figure that ARW's most successful year is the year of COVID. How does that happen?
Amen.
I think it's because people need to look for the positivity in life and that escape.
You're like the Amazon of pro wrestling. You made more money. You made more money with a worldwide pandemic.
I don't know how that works, but you know, here we are in 2021, and right now D3 and Remy going at it in the ring.
Flip switch. What's he doing? What's he doing?
He stated that. Oh,
pin 1-2.
It's like you stated though. D3 can kind of. He's a hybrid. He can adapt.
Oh, right there. Boom. Back. that Russian leg sweep.
He's a hybrid. He can adapt, and that's what he's doing right now, adapting to Remy. But you got to remember, Briscoe is still in this match.
Well, that's why I always say the third man's always the difference. And, kick to the head of Remy as he went up to the high-rent district.
It's a risk. It's high risk for a reason, and right now Remy is finding out why.
Oh, man, what they're about to do right now. B3 going up. They're struggling.
Taking off the top rope right there.
And there it is. Remy fighting back against D3. Wait a minute. He's not going to suplex him out of the ring.
Oh, my God.
No, not out the ring.
Absolutely not.
And they're still struggling.
It's anyone's game at this point. Very risky business up there, though.
And they put the next level championship.
Wait, and this is where Briscoe comes into play, that triple threat. God, Frank.
That's a Tower of Doom. No! No!
Oh, my God! I felt the ring shake from here.
And it's all about the gold here tonight, the Atomic Next Level Championship.
Which one of these competitors are going to walk out with the gold?
Clothesline.
Woo! Bad to the bone. The Prince of Rome.
And there he
is. Or the Briscoe.
Pushing.
I said the Briscoe. Or the Future.
Oh my God! To a DDT.
Wes has wrestling in his blood. And this right here is a main event if I ever saw it, Frank.
And there he is. Oh, the gut wrench power slam. And now he reverses.
But Remy going to reverse it.
Death drop. Death drop.
New champion.
Two.
Oh. How did he kick out of that, Frank?
I don't know. I don't know how he kicked out of that one.
He's the future. But is the future now is the question.
Well, D3 getting up and Remy setting him up. Misses. Hits the corner. Misses the kick.
Ooh, look at that athleticism by D3.
Blocks the punch. Uppercut. European uppercut. Super neck breaker out of nowhere.
Maybe I spoke too soon on Remy being new champion. D3 might be the next level champion when this match ends.
Blocks all the way up.
Oh! As he goes for the pin, but again, eyes in the back of your head because Briscoe is waiting and ready to fire.
And Remy getting underneath the rope so it doesn't count. Oh, no. Close. Turns.
Briscoe catches. What is he? Briscoe thinking.
DDT, no.
Oh,
yes.
Wow. What a reversal there by D3.
And there he goes. Catch him with a submission.
Oh my God. Wait a second.
Oh, brain buster. And it's over.
Of the match and still Atomic Next Level Champion, Bad to the Bone, Wes Briscoe.
Bad to the Bone, Wes Briscoe in 2021 is still next level, and he proved it here tonight, picking up a huge win against D3 and Remy.
Well, I guess the future as of right now is not for Remy, but his performance here tonight. Really absolutely telling.
You can take nothing away from D3 or Remy.
No.
Both very tough competitors. And nonetheless, though, Remy, he is the future. And tonight, if anything, he's earned another notch under his belt, proving that he is that future.
Well, listen, if they were able to keep up like this with a veteran like Wes Briscoe, I see big things for both of these gentlemen.
Absolutely. 2021 is going to be a great year for all involved. But nonetheless, congratulations, Mr. Bad to the Bone Briscoe, still your Atomic Next Level Champion.
On February 19, 2021, for the last time at the Space Coast Convention Center, we wage an all-out war as we begin Chapter 5, celebrating our 4-year anniversary. Scheduled to appear with ARW favorites like Wes Brisco, Shannon Moore, Jason Dugan, Kristen Dane, Remy, and more. Plus, we'll see the debuts of the co-founder of Guar, Techno Destructo, Trevor Aeon, The Awakening, formerly known as The Ascension, and one half of Primetime, KTG. And we'll see the returns of the Warlord of Weird, Sid Bodhi, current comeback star, Madman Furgeon, and impact star, The Undead Bride, Sue Young. It all goes down February 19, 2021, for Chapter 5, All Out 4, our 4-year anniversary celebration at the Space Coast Convention Center, 301 Tucker Lane, Inkerville, Florida. Tickets available now at eventbrite.com, keyword Atomic Wrestling.